turns out obese people age faster in blood. However, the strongest effect can be found in liver tissue. So obesity greatly accelerates the epigenetic age of liver tissue, you know.
Have you ever looked at how, so you mentioned obesity and how obesity is associated with an accelerated epigenetic age.
Yes.
Have you ever come across data with respect to the opposite of that, like fasting or even caloric restriction, if that slows the epigenetic aging?
Yeah, I mean, in mice, the answer is clear cut. Definitely caloric restriction slows the epigenetic clock in mice. And we know that because several groups have looked at it, including my group. All of us arrive at the same answer. Conversely, by the way, high fat diet, you know, accelerates the epigenetic age of mice, you know. So that's all clear cut, you know. The question though is really, what about humans, you know?
Right.
And I'm not aware of a study where people really looked at caloric restriction versus epigenetic aging. And but let me share some thoughts. When it comes to any intervention, including dietary intervention, that prevents anything related to metabolic syndrome or diabetes, that will be detectable, you know. So in other words, if you have an intervention that takes a very obese person to a lean person, in my opinion, grim age will pick that up. It has to, you know. However, when you ask the question, what about if you take a really relatively lean person, healthy body mass index 23, and you and this person is so motivated to live 10 years longer, and they pursue now a lifestyle where their BMI is, let's say, 17, you know, almost at the point of being unhealthy. And so if you compare a healthy person versus a semi-starved person, would that have a benefit? And in my opinion, that may not be the case. And I'm just speculating here. But even in according to other biomarkers, I personally haven't seen convincing studies, you know. Otherwise, I think my BMI would be 17 right now.
So that's the question. It's like, well, if you have these types of interventions on already healthy people, will they make any difference? At least according to epigenetic aging, right?